What's going on, YouTube? This is Seha Man back with another figure review, back with another Walking Dead figure review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Walking Dead Series 1 from the TV series. This is Daryl Dixon, and let me tell you guys off the bat that this figure is going to be the hardest one to get out of the four. I mean, because you can say, I guess there's five, because there's that variant Rick Grimes, which is actually really cool. But this one is going to be hard to get. Before they released these figures in stores, Frank and Sons already had the set, and the seller was selling every individual figure for 15 except him. He was already selling him for 40, and I wasn't about to pay 40 bucks for this figure. So then I tried looking online to see what eBay was selling for it, and they were, you know, it's already at 39 and 40, and these figures only cost $15 at Toys R Us. But and then I went back to Frank and Sons, and they're all out of Daryl Dixon. They're just completely sold out. And I happened to go to Toys R Us in the morning because they got the new shipment in, because you know they were all cleared out for Christmas, and they just got the new shipment in today. And I happened to go before work, and I found two Daryl Dixons, so I picked them both up, and it was only $15. And the I remember the seller at Frank and Sons was telling me that they're only going to have like two Daryl Dixons per box or whatever. So if you guys, you know, want a Daryl Dixon figure, you need to go to Toys R Us like early in the morning. Otherwise, people are going to get these figures. There's not going to be that many on the pegs. So, you know, stay alert if you really want a Daryl Dixon figure. Otherwise, you're going to be paying a lot of money for these small little figures. But, I mean, he is a cool figure. So let's take a look at the packaging. We'll do it real quick. Same packaging as the other ones. We'll do it right behind Daryl here. Same packaging. Walking Dead. Daryl Dixon. The back. We got the other figures. Now the humans are actually really cool from this series. I really enjoy this series compared to the comic series. This series really is good. Rick Grimes is awesome. Same with the variant, with the black and white one with the blood. Zombie Biter was cool. Daryl Dixon's actually pretty cool, even though he doesn't look like the figure I have here doesn't really look like the actor that plays him, but the picture shown here, he does look like the actor that plays him, so that's a little difference there. And he does come with a crossbow, squirrels, pickaxe, knife, and axe. And the only disappointment from this series was the zombie walker, because I really liked that zombie from the show. I thought he really looked cool, but he just looked like a cheap toy, and it really bummed me out, because I was looking forward to him the most. And Rick Grimes, these two were the ones I was really looking forward to, and Rick Grimes did not disappoint. The humans were actually really good in this series, and they did come with really cool accessories. So, okay, that's enough for the packaging. Let's get into Daryl's accessories he comes with, first off. Now, let me tell you guys off the bat right now, he does not hold his accessories good at all. The hand is open to a little too wide, where you try to have him hold the accessories, they just fit loose, they just wobble in his hand. But he does come with the pickaxe, he comes with an axe, and he does have a knife, a little knife, which is in his sheath. I'll get that out in a second. You can see that right there, there's the knife, it is removable, there you go. And you just put that right back in there. And he does come with squirrels. I'll show you guys in a second, that are wrapped around his shoulder. You can take this off, but I wrapped it around his shoulder. We'll get into that in a second. And he comes with his most famous weapon, the crossbow. Because, you know, Daryl Dixon is a badass, man. He doesn't use guns. This guy uses crossbows. So this is actually really nice. He's got a little string here, or strap, which is pretty nicely detailed. You can see the crossbows here. He's got the bow, or the arrows there. He's got the extra arrows right here on the side. The front view of it. Side view. He doesn't even hold this that great either, which is a bummer. But very cool. Very cool accessories. And we'll get a close-up on the squirrels here. See if I can zoom in. Those little dead squirrels. So this is the back of them. was a front. It's just crazy. You can see the ropes around their necks. Dead squirrels. And then there's a close-up on Rick Grimes. So what do you guys, or I'm sorry, Daryl Dixon. So what do you guys think? Does he look like the actor that plays him? I really don't think so. It's still a cool figure, though, but he does not look nothing like him. He looks like it's just some other dude. Nice detail on the face, though. You can see the little beard and all that. Really cool. The hair, too, looks pretty cool. Let's see. Let me show you an example of him holding his weapons. So we'll put this axe in his hand. You can see that there. See, it's just really loose. If you do it in the other one also, this one, his hands close a little more, but you get the same problem. He holds it like right about there to the top. Unless you want to do like two hands, you could probably do some kind of cool pose or something like that. I guess that's cool right there, but you're going to want to pose this guy with his crossbows. I mean, that's his signature weapon. But he's pretty nice. Nice looking figure. He's got the, you know, the same shirt as the actor wears, the dirty pants, or jeans. I like the shoes. The shoes actually look really cool. They're actually pretty detailed. So that's one thing I really like. And as far as articulation goes, the head can go side to side, up and down, and rotate. Or tilt side to side also. His arms can go in and out, forward and back. He's got a swivel in the arm. Can bend at the bicep. His wrists can go up and, you know, forward and back and rotate. He's got no waist articulation. Legs can go forward and back. He's got leg swivel. Bend at the knee. Does he bend at the knee? Dude, I don't even know. I don't even want to break this guy. But yeah, I guess he can bend at the knee. And he's got a lower leg swivel. Or he actually has a swivel in the knee. And his foot can rotate slightly. It can go up and down, though. But this one's a cool figure as well. But the only problem is he just doesn't look like the actor that plays Daryl Dixon. You can see the back here. He's got a bandana in the left side of his back pocket. And that knife with the sheath. Really cool. So he does come with some cool accessories, like I said. It comes with the pickaxe, the axe, the knife, the string full of dead squirrels, and his crossbows, which is really cool. Only problem, like I said, is that he does not hold them well. You can see if you put it in his hand, doesn't, there you go, so you can see it fits loose, doesn't really want to stay too well, but I mean, you just have to mess with it a little bit in order to get him in some kind of a pose, but I'm not really going to try too hard right now, for the sake of the video, otherwise I'll be doing this for freaking like 5 minutes trying to get him in a cool pose. You really have to take your time and have patience with these McFarlane Walking Dead figures. Let's see. Oh, jeez. Ah. But yeah, that's the only problem with this series is that, I mean, I didn't pick up the comic series, so I don't know how the accessories works on those figures, but if they hold accessories well or not. But these ones do not hold their weapons well. Come on, Daryl. This is your crossbows, dude. Hold them. Whatever. It's starting to piss me off. But anyways, here, let's get him. Let's get him holding his axe. I don't know. If you guys have this figure, tell me if you guys have the same problem with him holding his weapons, because I can't get him to hold his crossbows. It's too time consuming to do this on camera. But we'll get him holding the axe. We'll get him in some kind of a pose holding the axe. But yeah, this is Daryl Dixon from The Walking Dead TV series from Series 1 from McFarlane Toys. And like I said, guys, this figure is going to be the hard one to get, so make sure you jump on this, you know, as soon as you can if you really want to collect the series. Okay, guys, this is Seha Man. Hope you guys enjoyed my review, and we'll see you guys soon. You guys take care.